Now we are seeing a problem from the topic gas turbines. Let us see the problem. Find the required air fuel ratio in a gas turbine whose turbine and compressor efficiencies are 85% and 80% respectively. Maximum cycle temperature is 875 degrees centigrade. The working fluid can be taken as air, for which Cp value is 1.0 kilojoules per kg Kelvin and gamma 1.4, which enters the compressor at 1 bar and 27 degrees centigrade. The pressure ratio is 4. The fuel used has calorific value of 42,000 kilojoules per kg. There is a loss of 10% of calorific value in the combustion chamber. And if you see here the given data, efficiency of turbine and compressors are given. Turbine efficiency is 85% and compressor efficiency is 80%. So these are nothing but isentropic efficiencies of turbine and compressor. So turbine efficiency is 84% means eta T you can take 0.85. Compressor efficiency 80% means eta C you can take it as 0.8. Maximum cycle temperature. See, if you observe TS diagram for the simple gas turbine, with the considering the turbine and the compressor efficiencies or compression and expansion efficiencies, if you consider, so this is a diagram showing a TS diagram for this simple gas turbine by considering the efficiencies. So in the cycle T3 will be the maximum temperature. So that maximum temperature is given 875 degrees centigrade, so that is T3 we are taking, and in kelvins it is 1148 kelvins. Cp value is given 1.0 kilojoules per kg Kelvin and the gamma is given 1.4, and the working fluid, that is air, is entering the compressor. The pressure of 1 bar is given, so you can take it as P1. So 1 bar and initial temperature are entering, the air is entering at temperature of 27 degrees centigrade, or it is 300 kelvins, and pressure ratio is given here. Pressure ratio is 4 given. So pressure ratio, you can take it as a P2 by P1. If you observe here, the gas turbine generally works between two pressures in a simple gas turbine. So let us take it as a P2 and a P1. So you can write pressure ratio as P2 by P1. So that pressure ratio is P2 by P1 is 4. Such that P1 is given 1 bar, so P2 will become 4 bars. And calorific value of fuel is given 42,000 kilojoules per kg. So you can take it as a capital C, calorific value 42,000 kilojoules per kg. And efficiency of the combustion, you can take it as 90%. Why? Because there is a 10% of loss of calorific value in the combustion chamber. So you can take efficiency of combustion, for example, eta CC as a symbol. So it's a 90%, 10% loss means 90% efficiency, or it is 0.9. And here we have to find out air fuel ratio. So that is, if you take MA is the mass of air used and MF is the mass of fuel used per kg of air, something like that. If you take, so here we have to find out MA by MF, this ratio, that is air fuel ratio, we have to find out here. So to find out air fuel ratio, we'll use this formula, that is heat supplied by the fuel is equals to heat taken by the burning gases. So there is a 10% of loss. So taking 90% is efficiency, so that we can write a heat supplied by the fuel as 0.9 into MF, mass of the fuel, into calorific value of fuel, and that is we are equating to the heat taken by the burning gases. So you can see here, only air is entering into the compressor and it is compressed and it is given to the combustion chamber. So here fuel, some amount of fuel, some mass of fuel is used along with the air to heat that air. So here after if you means the burning gases exiting from this combustion chamber are nothing but hot gases, or those are called burning gases, which will consist of air and mass of air and mass of fuel. So mass of hot gases or burning gases, we can write it as MA plus MF, so that here we can write MA plus MF and CP into, that is a specific heat of air, or here gases also will take same because only one value is given, and T3 minus T2 dash. we observe here the hot gases are having T3 temperature before entering to the turbine, and after they are leaving we are taking it as a T4 dash. It is the temperature of hot gases after leaving the turbine. So the difference of temperature will be T3 minus T4 dash. So by using this equation we can find out this MA by MF, because we can just simplify this. We can send this terms here, so we can write here, you can write this form as a MA by MF form. If you see here, MA by MF form, and by substituting all other this known value and all these values, we can find out this ratio. So before that, we require here to simplify that, we require T3 and T2 dash. So T3 anyway is given, and here we have to find out T2 dash. So to find out T2 dash, once again, we'll use this formula, the efficiency of compressor formula, that is isentropic efficiency of compressor formula. So here we have T2 dash. So from this, we can find out T2 dash. So here we require T2 also. T1 is anyway, it is given. 27 degrees centigrade or 300 Kelvin is given, and this is also given. So to find out T2 dash, we require T2. So to find out T2, we'll use or we'll consider the process 1 to 2. So if you see, the process 1 to 2 is nothing but reversible adiabatic compression. So here only just consider only this 1 to 2, not 1 to 2 dash. Just if you concentrate on this process 1 to 2, this is a isentropic process, or this is nothing but reversible adiabatic process. So anyway, the process is adiabatic process. So for adiabatic process, you can write T2 by T1 is equals to P2 by P1 whole to the power of gamma minus 1 by gamma, relation between temperature and pressure. So here pressure ratio is given 4 and gamma is 1.4 minus 1 by 1.4. Just if you simplify that, we are getting T2 by T1 as 1.486. And from that, you can write T2 is T1 into 1.486. And T1, it is a given data, it is 300 kelvins. If you simplify that, we are getting T2 as 445.8 kelvins. And from that, we are substituting the T2 value in the compressor isentropic efficiency of compressor formula. So that is T2 minus T1 by T2 dash minus T1. So friends, for the explanation of this formula, just refer my previous video on gas turbines, that is problem 1 and gas turbines. So if you refer that video, just you will get the explanation for this formula. So anyway, here the compressor efficiency is given 80%, or it is 0.8. T2 we have calculated 445.8 kelvins, and T1 is given 300 kelvins, and T2 dash we have to find out, and it is once again 300. So just when you rearrange this, you can write like this, and if you simplify this, we are getting T2 dash as 482.2 kelvins. And I told we'll use this formula to find out air fuel ratio, that is heat supplied by the fuel is equals to heat taken by the burning gases. So here I told, because there is a 10% of loss we have discussed anyway, so we can write 90% is a efficiency of combustion. So you can write 0.9 into MF into C, that is a heat supplied by the fuel. It's a formula you can write, and heat taken by the burning gases, you can write MA plus MF, that is a total mass of hot gases, into CP into T3 minus T2 dash. So just if you send this two terms here, so it will be dividing here, and rearrange here. So writing MF for this first term and 0.92 here. So just rearranging the terms here. So here once again, you can write this MF for these two terms individually. So we can write MA by MF plus MF by MF into CP T3 minus T2 dash by 0.9. Just separating here, and see calorific value is given 42,000. So we have taken anyway this 90% or 0.9 here along with the MF. Anyway, we have taken the first itself. Can write C value just here, it is 42,000, and MA by MF, this is MF by MF is 1, and CP value is given 1, and T3 is given 1148, and T2 dash we have calculated 482.2 is a 0.9 as it is, and just simplify that. If you simplify this term, we are getting as 739.78, and this we are writing the right side, MA by MF plus 1. So if you write only this term, or if you write for only MA by MF, so this is dividing here, and this is a plus means here it is minus. So if you simplify that, we are getting MA by MF as 55.77. So you can write that directly as MM is air and MF is fuel. So that you can write directly air fuel ratio as 55.77 is to 1. So here nothing is there means by 1. So you can write the air fuel ratio as 55.77 is to 1, or if you round off this to the ratio, the next value, so it will be 56, this value. So otherwise you can write air fuel ratio as 56 is to 1. So this is the way to solve this kind of question. So for more videos, please subscribe and activate bell symbol. And also please share my videos with your friends. So don't forget to subscribe. And anyway, thanks for watching.